reminiscing today and using the all-time, old-time goodies and all that stuff.
And to me, we have a culture surpassed by no other civilization, but we don't know anything about it.
I think you can always write something with that the people will understand.
Thank God that he gave me the energy to carry out the role. But I was just playing a part for humanity, and I'm still playing a part for humanity. That's my role.
Hello all, hello all. Thank you so much for joining us today. I'm your most gracious host, Distinguished Legacy. This is another episode of Soundtrack to My Life. Glad to be here again, at home, man, live from Humane Studios, somewhere on the east side of Atlanta. And today I have a special guest of mine, a friend of mine, someone that I lean on in times that I need advice. I offer advice as well, so I mean, it's just a great honor and a blessing to have him on today, my brother Todd Lansden. How you doing, brother?
Appreciate you for having me here, man.
Absolutely, absolutely, man. It was just a matter of time, man. We finally got you situated. I know we wanted to get you on prior to. You had your college basketball schedule that, of course, that was kind of conflicting with things, but I told you it was going to happen, and here we are. So we're looking to rock and roll. You got some important things that you want to discuss, so we're going to go ahead and get into it. But without further ado, we're going to go ahead and shout out some sponsors. Shout out to Makeshift Almighty. Shout out to Worldwide Winds. Shout out to Humane Studios. And shout out to Maybe I'm Tripping Podcast, man. Those are the guys that put forth the time and the latitude and the resources to help us do what we do. So we're going to keep it rolling in honor of them. So, Todd, what's been up with you, man? How you doing, brother? Your vibration high?
Just been busy, bro.
Busy. Absolutely.
That's all
I've been. Yeah, man. And that's a lot to say the least. And it ain't just a cliche term with you saying that you're busy, because you're actually involved in a lot of different things. Do you care to speak, like, what when you mean busy, could you shed light to the people on what are some of the things that you've been doing here in the past recent month or two that may lead to you being busy?
Well, going to Italy, play basketball, Rome, Italy. It was a blessing. God blessed me to be able to do that. Graduated, and I just got blessed with that opportunity. Earlier this year, it was kind of sketchy at first.
Right.
Me and my family did like a lot of research, and I actually leave Tuesday. So
awesome. Yeah.
Outside of basketball, you know, I told you about those rental properties that's on my street.
Right.
So that's basically what I've been trying to get into, my rental properties and real estate.
Right.
And right now we're just fixing that up, working on the floors and the roof and everything, and that should be up in September.
Awesome.
So I have it rented out while I'm gone, and I'll
awesome.
Get back in May for that.
Awesome, man.
Of course, I got my clothing line, Makeshift Almighty Apparel.
There you go.
Yeah, shouted that out earlier.
Yeah.
This is one of my mini shirts. It's actually one of my favorite shirts. It's the Makeshift Torah. It's
dope.
Tiger in Japanese, because, you know, I like the anime and all this stuff.
Yeah.
Gotta keep the class.
Absolutely. Before we get into it, man, if I'm somebody who's never heard of Makeshift Almighty and I'm looking to purchase some of your items or anything like that, how do I go about that process? What do you have, an Instagram page? Do you have a website?
Yeah.
All that stuff, man. If you know any of it, shout it out.
Yeah, you can follow me on Instagram at Makeshift Almighty. That's Makeshift Almighty. The website is also makeshiftalmighty.com. You can also Google Makeshift Almighty. We have a good Google presence. So it's really just a household name getting close, especially in like local areas. But
awesome, man. That's dope, bro. And for the listeners, how old are you again?
23.
So at 23 years old, when I was 23, man, I was, of course, out of college and trying to figure out the slightest thing to do in my life, man. Any job, anybody that was looking to pay me, I was going to work. The last thing I was thinking about was how to propel my future in a way of starting a family business. You know what I mean? Finishing school, going to study abroad and things like that. So you want an apparel, man, you on a level that most people, you know, aren't even thinking about yet, man. So like, I just want to applaud you and commend you as a young man, but also as a leader in your community, bro, for doing that. I think that's something that is extremely important and people need to hear about it, bro. So that's not something that should be slept on. That's something to be admired and appreciated. But of course, as you all know, we here to discuss, you know, classic conversation, of course, speaking about things that empower people. But we also here to discuss the music as well. We couldn't be here without the music. The music is the things that bind us together. It's the universal language. So without further ado, we're here discussing one of Kanye West's most momentous classic projects, all-time projects, My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, man.
The greatest album of all time.
And that is why I have him here. So, if you could be so kind, when you think of My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy, like, if you could just think of just some quick action words that come to your mind or anything that you can remember, like, let's say, better question. When it first came out, you as a Ye fan, like, what was your thought process?
I mean, really with any Kanye album, it's okay. Like, because, you know, he's always going to push it back.
Right. I
mean, even now with Donda, he's right. Pushing it back week after week after week. So, right. As a Kanye fan, when you get the album, you just appreciate it.
Okay.
You're just happy to actually have it in your hands.
Right.
But with this album, when I first heard it, it was like, light changing on this.
Right.
It's like, people nowadays don't really respect Kanye as a rapper.
Right.
Stuff like that. I respect Kanye as a musician.
Right.
Because I feel like Kanye sets himself on a different level as far as it's bigger than rap.
Right.
He's a music maker.
Right.
Like, he makes music. Like, I don't listen to Kanye just for the bars. I listen to the sound, the beat, everything. And I think he's one of the only artists that is good at making the bars, the beat, the sounds, everything come together
right.
To make a song.
Right.
And that's why I like Kanye.
Absolutely. I mean, of course, he's a music mogul and a super producer. I just remember, of course, I remember the hype surrounding it, right? Because I remember hearing just in the early Twitter sphere and the social media space, hearing about him, you know, sending all these great, talented writers and artists off to Hawaii. Like, I remember, you know, hearing about Nicki Minaj and Saha the Prince, Pusha T, Rick Ross, you name it, those guys, he paid for those guys to be flown out to Miami and treated them while worked extremely hard to come out with a great body of work. So if you could be so kind, man, to pick it up and, you know, just pull the cover off of it. Let's see. Ye usually does a great job of giving us some cool artwork. I know this is hurting you to uncover it right now, but we gonna do this for the people, bro.
I know. And it's the really interesting thing about this album is this was right after the Taylor Swift incident.
Right.
And, you know, he was disappeared for like a year.
Right.
A year or two.
Right.
And then just to come out with this great body of work.
See, open
the cover
up.
Art.
Yeah.
This really wasn't the first cover art. This was the third.
Uh-huh.
You got the back cover right here. This art. That's just crazy.
The attention to detail, man, the time and effort it takes into him understanding the importance of his artwork is
crazy.
It's crazy, man. That's so dope.
They don't do it like this anymore, man.
Nah. Nah. So if you could be so kind, man, to I guess fold it up to where you can, or I'm sure you don't even have to need the track listing, because I know how important this project is to you. When me and you working out in the gym, we done played My Beautiful Dark Twisted Fantasy several times on several different occasions. So if you could name, man, a couple songs that stick out to you, what songs you appreciate more than others, just anything, just rock out.
Favorite song is probably Devil in New Dress.
Okay.
Devil in New Dress. My favorite, anthem
yeah.
is probably Power.
Okay.
Because of the meaning behind it, and also
right.
the bars.
Right.
And my favorite, chill, to listen to, is Gorgeous.
Right.
And, yeah
Gorgeous. Gorgeous, man. I'm like you, man, pretty much. I'm on par with everything you just said. But if I would go Monster. Monster is dope. I would go Gorgeous. But my favorite two is, which I'm gonna go second first, with So Appalled.
Mm-hmm.
So Appalled was crazy, man. Saha the Prince actually being able to stand toe to toe with some of the rap's best lyricists of all time.
Slept on.
So Appalled, and of course Devil in a New Dress. I think Kanye West's, you know, just musical delivery on that project, along with Rick Ross laying one of, I would say, arguably at least 25 to 25 verses in hip hop period. Mm-hmm. I feel like he put himself in a different category with the work he did on that. Go ahead.
I just feel like his album brought the best out of everybody that was on it.
There you
like,
go.
He made, I know Nick Minaj tells stories about how he made her rewrite her verse.
Right.
And she ended up watching Kanye and Jay-Z
there you
on
go.
One song.
Absolutely.
And it brought the best out of Kanye, of course, Jay-Z,
right.
Sahai the Prince,
right.
All of them, Rick Ross.
Right, yeah.
Really, everybody on it. And then you look at the records it's broke. Just this last decade, it was voted number one and number two on three different, on Billboard, Pitchfork, and one other website.
Right.
Best album of all genres
right.
in a decade, number
right.
one, number two.
Right.
And that's like Michael Jackson, all this stuff.
Right.
Everything.
Right.
And that sounds crazy.
Man.
Especially for him to be like a rapper to do that.
Right.
And like, rap.
Right.
Started becoming like mainstream.
Right.
Probably like 2018.
Right.
19.
Right.
For him to beat out like, you know, pop, rock and roll, all that other stuff.
Right.
But number one, that's crazy.
Absolutely, absolutely. And for you to do so many things in the creative space, I guess, how important is his music to what you do in the creative space?
I just feel like I use Kanye, well, a lot of people use Kanye as like a beacon of like what to do.
Right.
Like I use me, for example, like you used to tell me how earlier I'm 23 doing all this stuff. It's because I just dive in.
Right.
And I feel like that's what Kanye does. You just dive in and stuff. Like
right.
when I was young, I never really wanted to work, so I sold ties.
Right.
I stopped doing that, started selling t-shirts
right.
and hoodies and stuff.
Right.
And I had an opportunity to buy these rental properties on my street, and I just dove for it.
Right.
I mean, I read books and stuff like that, but I'm not like an expert at anything that I do.
Right.
But I just feel like if you stop just to think, you're stopping the possibility of making a shift, making it happen.
There you go.
So,
I get it. Now I can see, now that you brought that to light, I can see the correlation in between the two work ethics. And he too had done some great things at the, you know, at the young age of 23. So
yeah.
you in good company and well, and you well on your way, man. So if you had to pick a song that you wanted people to hear and they exit, or something to rock out to, what would be your song of choice and why?
Easily Devil in New Jersey.
Why?
The bars, the beat, Rick Ross verse, Kanye verse. Like I said, I'm just a fan of sound.
Right.
Like, it's more than just rap singing to me. Like, just the sound of guitar solo.
Right.
It's just everything. It's like a complete song.
Right.
Like, and it's, you can't say that a lot about a lot of people. Like, it's just a complete song.
I agree. I think that song spans all across all genres, man. That's probably the only song that you can get off on a rap album, man. You probably could play it something like a damn orchestra or something like that, and it'll still fit the mold. So I would agree with you. So we gonna rock out, man. If you can be so kind, let's take a look in there, see if we can find it, man, and see if we can put it on.
I love it though, you know? Put your hands to the constellations. The way you look should be a sin. You my sensation. I know I'm preaching to the congregation. We love Jesus, but you done learned a lot from Satan. Nina did a lot of waiting. We ain't married, but tonight I need some consummation. May the Lord forgive us, may the gods be with us. In that magic hour, I seen good Christians make rash decisions. Oh, she do it, what happened to religion? Oh, she lose it, she putting on her makeup. She casually a lord. Text message breakups, the casualty of tours. How she gon' wake up, and that love me no more. I thought I was that, I guess it's rubbing off. Hood phenomenon.
Ew.
The LeBron rhyme. Hard to be humble when you stunting on a jumbotron.